The stream title tells you everything you need to know about me today. I was busy rocking out to the song. Well, this is, after all, one of the streams with the best stream music. I'm totally not biased in any way. I mean, my name is not Tobias for any reason. Too biased? I don't know. It's a terrible pun, I'm sorry. That was a Lorraine level pun. Although this is a certifiably bad idea. Drinking tea in a room in front of two gigantic studio lights with a green screen behind me and a gigantic power-hungry monster of a computer below me. I'm sitting in a tiny little box in my room. I mean, the room is pretty large. It's just that the green screen just blocks everything off. So it gets incredibly hot, or warm, I guess, here where I'm sitting. So drinking tea is probably not the greatest of ideas that you can come up with. But tea, your argument is invalid. So considering that World Anvil is having some issues today, I haven't actually figured out if they've fixed it yet. But from what I hear, there is some issues with our World Anvil right now. So I'm just gonna peruse the Discord and see if they fixed it. Apparently did not post that in announcements. I saw the message. Where did he post it? Changelog? Come on, Discord. There it is. Extreme load on the system right now. We'll be restarting the service. Please make sure you progress. Save your projects externally. Okay. Well, I think we'll be fine anyway. Question is how much that affects, because we'll mostly be moving articles around, and I do press the manual save a lot. I'm like in the Arctic Circle or something. It's not that far north, you know. Sweden is actually a pretty long country. If you flipped Sweden on, like, if you pinned it on the southern tip and flipped it southwards, you would end up somewhere south of Italy. That's how long Sweden is. So, yes, the northern parts are north of the Arctic Circle, but most of Sweden is actually below the Arctic Circle, believe it or not. It's not that bad, trust me. Hello, Kajetan, I hope you are doing well. Nice to see you. I'm just having a chill tea time while waiting for the people to drop in. Because I have noticed something that even though I have like a 15-minute warm-up timer, most of the people seem to show up like after I go actually live, which is like at 6. That's where most people show up. So I wonder if I should just delay my stream and have a shorter warm-up time and just start later. I don't know. Yeah, I'm not gonna be... I'm not gonna risk losing anything. What I will lose at most is like... Oh no, it didn't save the category. Oh no! Also, hello dinosaurs! How are you doing? Are you evolved today? I hope you're doing well, and I hope your stream was... I almost said profitable, but I meant productive. Bob. Like, you have three parts of your name. You have RPG, dinosaur... I almost did that. RPG, dinosaur, and Bob. It's like, which part of these do you pick? Do you just say RDB? Do I call you dinosaur? Do I call you Bob? Bob seems most fitting. So Bob it is. I hope your stream went well. We're just having a chill tea time. Waiting for people to drop in. And also giving World Anvil some time to breathe, because apparently they're having problems right now. I'm doing professional lurking, kind of in the middle of seeing how far back I can track my family. That seems like a rabbit hole. I like, by the way, Lorraine, that you put "Welcome Raiders of the Lost Park" and a question mark at the end. Are you welcome? Are you not welcome? Do you want to be welcomed? And now chat died. Cool. Thanks, Twitch. It's very interesting because I see chat right there, but the actual chat on the chat window died. You can only call me RPG or Bob or Dino Bob. Just never call me late for dinner. Bob works. Bob definitely works. Okay, this is still way too hot to drink. Tea is very hot, but I'm gonna sip anyway because tea is good. I have become an actual tea drinking person. It's weird how that happened, but it happened. Okay. Now that everyone is here, and I hope you are seated comfortably, and I will jump into world and we'll see how utterly bad we can break it. Which is probably going to be very. I just had food. Maybe I should get some tea too. Tea is always good. It's worse when my words are hard. Worse than when brain is moving faster in a sentence than mouth. I don't know. That's what happened to me most of the time. That's why my English is terrible. And why I go a lot. Because my brain is like three sentences ahead and my mouth can't keep up. Okay, so I have a theory. We're gonna find something and throw it into a category just to see if it is broken. Yes. Question is what? The purple mist is going to be on the Skaska waterfront. We'll start with that one. World Demo servers had to be rebooted. World Demo performance was very, very slow this morning. I had to give up and switch to Incarnate. Yeah, there's apparently something going on with the servers. According to Dimmy, it was excessive load, and I guess that means it's a DDoS attack, because I don't think World Anvil just suddenly goes over capacity. That doesn't seem likely. So we're gonna go purple mist, Skaska waterfront, Fusion City, location, entertainment, why is that so hard to spell? Entertainment, pub, bar, restaurante, purple mist, Skaska waterfront. There we go, that's a lot of tags. Save. It claims it's saved. We'll see. Have a good stream. Time for me to get some lunch. Bon appetit, Bob. And have a nice time. By saving externally, they usually mean copy and paste what you were typing into a Word document or something. Yeah. That's usually what it means. It loads fast enough. Parent location, Skaska waterfront. That's not what I was looking for. Yeah, it did. It did. So, saving and loading seems to function fine. Also, this is Snork's bar. No, not Snork. No, wait, his name is Snork. Yes. His nickname is Snork. Who was I thinking about? I was thinking of a snitch. Oh. People have two similar names. This is Snork. AKA Snork. So Snork also needs to move into there. Edit person. I have successfully tracked a straight line from me to a dude who was born before 1600. That's way back. I do not think I would have the patience for that. He's gonna be under the purple mist. So this character is a person. He is a minor person. He is plot related. He's a Dalsun. I see moose. Or no, I just saw things moving. Okay. Wow, my webcam is laggy as balls today. Oh well, it happens, I guess. Why, hello there, James. How are you doing? It's good to see you. I think I'm just gonna snork Sirtr Grimtusk. Chib changes. A person whose job it is to change changes. Wait, to change town clocks is called what? A hunchback? I have no idea. Clock worker? Clockmaster? I don't know. Timekeeper, I guess. My family has a family tree going back that far and into modern northern Germany. I think the Finnish side also tracked similarly since they took the Thor surname out of apparently spite when the government required surnames instead of patrilinear names. Ah. Oh, I was seeing a moose. Hey, Cadence. That hasn't happened before. I see. Well, if you look over on the moose cam, you can see something moving around there in the corner. That's Cadence. Cadence is usually the one who's fighting, but she's out eating, and I hear meep meeps from under the stump that they live in. So I guess someone is viciously grooming someone in there. Sorry, I was talking about you. Okay. I still haven't gotten out of Middle Norway on my dad's side, so I guess I'm pretty local. Yup. I'd say. Okay. Where is Skaska Waterfront? It's a perimeter district, right? So if we go just straight to Fusion City, we should be able to get down to Sirtr Grimtusk by just following links. So from here, we go to the bottom to contained articles. We go to well, apparently not. All right, fine. Perimeter. Also, this should probably be changed too. Perimeter is not a da-da-da-da. It's not. Oh, it's not a central. I'm stupid.
I am an idiot.
So, okay. No, I was there. I was where I was supposed to be. I asked the timekeeper, is this timekeeper recorded time spent on activities, a clerk who records staff working on hours, oh. Oop. Seven Ingebrigt, son of Ingebrigt. That's like Rolf, son of Rolf of the House of Rolf. All right, so from Fusion City, we go to Central. From Central, we go to Perimeter. From Perimeter, we go to Skaska Waterfront. From Skaska Waterfront, we go to the Purple Mist. And from the Purple Mist, we get to Snork. Amazing. It works. I mean, of course it works, but you know, it's just a good way to explore things in a different kind of way. Because it was not great before. Ask. You're welcome. I can't really trace my family because World War II scattered the family in the documents all over Poland, a couple of few other countries. Wow. Welp. That doesn't sound great. Also, this is a problem. I have Azan Hadar here, which is a character. I have no idea who that is. or who he's related to, or she, or what. Azan Hadar is apparently a person, but there's nothing in the articles. I have no idea who it is. Exciting. Welp. All right, so we're gonna keep working on the uncategorized articles and just throw them into categories. Speaking is hard. So, to be sorted. This is stuff that I don't know where it's going to be. No, actually, we'll start by throwing stuff in other articles. So the cataclysmus. I don't know where that's gonna end up. Kayla. Sword of Kayla, Neck and Wolfbird, Creatures of the Dark, Dunia, Kajat, Smoothskin, Gelshir. Gelshir honestly should probably actually be under Kuna. Maybe Aizen was mentioned somewhere so you can check the reference in the list. I haven't checked that list. I have searched for Azan Kadar, but haven't found any. But that is a possibility, yes.
Azan Kadar.
Hey, Moose. Referenced in. Probably nowhere. No matches found.
Balls.
That's a great. So, Gelshir should be under Kuna. Condition, Kuna, Gelshir. Congenital. That is how you spell that, right? I think so, yes. Okay, stop being so hunched over, man.
Straighten your back and your neck. Do not sit like this. This is not good for your neck, okay? You're going to get into pain. If you do this, straighten up. Not good for your neck or your shoulders. It's bad, okay?
Mostly talking to myself, but you know. Yes, that was culture. So this is now gone.
Be gone.
Characters.
Ban An.
Lorraine. She should be under the corporation that made her. She, that Lorraine, should be under the Children of the Cataclysm. Ban An Atiesh is the leader of the Eaters of the Dead, yes? Lorraine Alay should be under Children of the Cataclysm. She is one of the cardinals. Safe. Smartphone neck is common. Yes.
Yes. I'm very good at hunching.
I shouldn't be.
Ban An Atiesh.
I'm fairly sure this is the leader of the Aegis of the Dead. Referenced in. No matches found, huh? Great. But I'm pretty sure that is the case. So we'll go with View Eaters of the Dead. Leader, Ban An Atiesh. Yes. Ban An Atiesh. The leader of the
Eaters of the Dead.
So, person. Major. Leader. Eaters of the Dead. I don't even know what species he is. Apparently, I haven't made up my mind about that. But he belongs to
organization. Affiliated organization.
Eaters of the Dead. chaotic stupid. He is blighted. I'm gonna mess with him later. Eatarth of the Dead. There we go. So characters. Baugrith Gjallaur. Who the balls is that? Sounds like a CEO. Famous architect. Oh, yeah. All right. The inventor of 3D printed buildings.
Beginnings.
He designed Thalcorp Tower, if I'm not wrong. So, person, miner, architect, Thalcorp Tower, and I believe Baugrith Gjallar. Actually, that's a tla, the Gjallar. Baugrith Gjallar. He should be... Wow. Baugrith Gjallar. That slug was murdered. Now here's the question, though. Do you see referenced anywhere else? No, I think I'm just going to put him on the Thalcorp Tower. Also, they spell like this for some reason. Thalcorp Tower. Because he's not really referenced anywhere else. He might be in the future, but right now he's not. That leaves us with Lyrain. And who made her? Lyrical Register Artificial Intelligence Enhanced, aka Lyrain. Ceres made her? That's possible, yes. Her owners, Ceres Electronics. Cool. So she should be under Ceres. Is she owned by Ceres Electronics or Ceres Incorporated? She was probably made by Ceres Electronics, but I think Ceres Incorporated owns her. Nah. We'll put her under Electronics. Ceres Electronics.
Bread into the oven. Bread.
That leaves us with characters being empty, so we can delete it. Then we have these categories, and species should probably be first. Shadowmark. Well, these are going to be organized whenever. The Abyss. Fusion City. The criminal organizations are probably going to be under the district where they have their headquarters.
I am bread.
Oh, whoops. Scooty McMoose. The powder kegs, you should be under the shadow mark. And crumb snatchers should probably be under cybernetics. Cybernetics. Fusion City, criminal, chrome snatcher. That was not how you spell that. Red Baron, butcher. Red Barons, butchers, and chrome snatchers. Yes, butcher, cybernetics. And you are left with Mr. Miss Hadar. I think that's an unorganized, which makes it even worse. It's an unsorted one. Oh, that last piece of tea was a bit bitter. Fusion City. I was looking in here. Criminal organizations. So the Zanga Brotherhood have their headquarters in Shinsen Heights. Yeah. No. Really? I was pretty sure they had their headquarters in Shinsen Heights. But we shall look at the map.
Death before disloyalty.
Shinsen Heights. Yeah, this is kind of their area. The Tlasa Downs, the Volgan Park, and Shinsen Heights. So we're gonna put them under Shinsen Heights. Shinsen!
Nani?
You haven't created Shinsen Heights? What? What shame for display! Why though? This is central. Shinsen Heights. There is an article for it. Fusion City District Central, Shinsen Heights. Why can't I link it? Might be like the Eater of the Dead leader person who is also not having any matches in the reference list. Yeah. I'm gonna guess it's someone in the Powder Kegs or in the Desert Raiders. What are they called again? The Sand Stalkers?
Zanga Hoshuda!
But Shin... There it is. Shinsen Heights. Good. So, Fusion City... Criminal, Gang, Zanga Brotherhood, Zanga Hoshuda, Shinsen Heights, Zalik as... How the fuck does he spell his name? Zalik Ashazi. There we go. Zalik Ashazi. Sandstalkers, yeah. Maybe it was a placeholder link and you just created art. That's also a possibility, actually. Which would mean that Shinsen Heights does not properly link to other articles.
We must fix it!
What? Oh, I was like, wow, have I written this much about Shinsen Heights? Huh? But no, no. that's the Zanga Hoshuda. So... Yeah, this doesn't link to any. This is correct. It was a placeholder link and I just created it.
That explains everything.
So this one should be under sand. Should it though? Shinsen is technically... Shinsen is one of those obnoxious districts that are both perimeter and downtown. No, it isn't really. It is kind of downtown. Most of Skaska is downtown, so Shinsen is probably also. Also, it's next to Aspen. Yes, it's perimeter. Hello? Not finding that name in Sandstalkers, and Powder Kegs are likely still a draft since I can read them. Yeah, the Powder Kegs, I haven't written anything about Powder Kegs specifically. I've written about their settlement, which is Bullet Creek. Shinsen Heights. So, Shinsen Heights should be under perimeter. leaves us with view bullet. Bullet. No, that's Orkudgach. Could it be something in Haven then? There's an article named Haven, bro. No, there isn't. Because it's not written yet. No. Because it's owned by the Promised Land. That's run by Boslik. Boslik. No Aizan Kadar. I have a growing suspicion that that's a plot character. So let me look at my notes.
If I can get to my notes, that is. Come on! Cooperate!
Freaking notebook. Alright. Okay, let's us have a look. Oh, Windswift. I was like, what is this? Nothing. Sasha. Sasha is a great character. Candles. Oh, easily fixed. Better? I am so confused. Nowhere in my notes. Now I have a problem. Who the F is this guy? Aizan Kadar. Part of the chain ringers? I lowered it about 30%, so it should be a big difference. No. Angel Syndicates? Probably not. Goptach? No, there's nothing there. Goptach? No. Oh my god, why? Who is Aizan Kadar? Dark Shadows article that was mistakenly made in COTC? Not likely. Could he be in Into the Abyss? No, because that's the other campaign. Where are those notes? Because that's another adventure. I think he's part of this gang here. That's the thing. whatever. Important people. Orkulgach is a part of the thing. Galwandradic is a part of the web. Ajlik Ben Edge. She works for Mengwele. Ofush Bishdum is from the Zanga Brotherhood. Ajlan is. What's a Children of the Cataclysm? Zalik is from Zanga. Bozlik is from Haven. Tupek Ktlach is a police officer. Was a police officer.
Orkudgach.
You should be under the powder kegs. Powder kegs. So, Pearson.
Major.
Leader. Powder kegs. Bullet Creek. And that's private for some reason, I don't know why.
Leader of the powder kegs.
Yes, correct. Galwin Dradek. Galwin is no one. She doesn't belong to anyone. But she kinda exists on the web, so we're gonna put her under the web. Or are we just gonna put her straight under Fusion City because she's such a massive part of the setting? She's probably just gonna go straight under Fusion City, I think. So, Fusion City, Person, Major, Plot, Galwin Dradic, Journalist, Sneak. Sneak is kind of the slang word for journalists. They're called sneaks or snoops. So, snoop, probably. They love slang in Fusion City. By the way, if you haven't noticed. Wee woo! It's still my favorite thing. I will never stop being happy about wee woo. Sneak Snoop! Exactly. Wololo! Wololo is actually not slang though, believe it or not. Ow. Frig me, that was hot. Wololo is actually a marketing term. So it's not slang. I want more tea, that's if you're wondering what I'm doing. More tea!
Wololo! Ayayoyo!
I'm a devoted follower of Wololo. Let's see. Wololo.
Wololo. Ayoyo.
So Wololo means winsome, luminant, open light oscillation. Oscillation. Yep. Casa surfaces. Should probably create that. Yes.
Wololo. Hi-yo-yo.
I have so many of those that I actually keep a document in my notebook keeping track of all the references so that if, when I publish this game and people start finding these and compile lists, I can compare my list of those I intentionally put in to the list that people are making. Because internet is internet. Material. Add. Commercial. Casa Surfaces.
Wololo.
The 2003 Age of Empires game was totally not the way I mentally lost years. Totally not. Oops. I didn't even know you could do that. Apparently you can click that multiple times. Create new article. Casa Surfaces Incorporated. Organization. Probably not very important, but they exist. Chef. Oh, technology. technology. That's what we are missing. I was actually upset that another game used the same name, so now I have to specify which group of Age of Empires I mean. I don't know what you mean there. What is this, though? This is... optic. An optic material. I was never very good at the game. Me neither. And honestly, once, like, I found Supreme Commander, every other real-time strategy game was just not interesting anymore. I got hardcore spoiled by Supreme Commander. Why are we here? Oh, Galwyn. Yeah, we did put her under Fusion City. Azlik Azlik Ben Edge. Ms. Ben Edge is a high-level official at Mgwele Neurologics. Mgwele Neurologics. So, Fusion City, person, fuck, person, Mgwele. Neurologics. Mgwele. Azlik Ben Edge. Minor. Ovush Bidun Bishdun. That was the previous leader of the Zanga Brotherhood until Zalik Arjazi killed him. Zutrusa, the Zanga Brotherhood. Fusion City, person, deceased, leader, Zanga Brotherhood, Zanga Oshuda, no, not Oshuda, Hoshuda, and the Sutrusa. And he should be under Zanga Brotherhood. Rush Bishdum, Arslan Mpok. So, Fusion City, person, major, plot, Cinders of Zikata. No, not Cinders. What am I doing? Children of the Cataclysm. This is your boss, Lirain. Well, the boss of one of you. Leader. Kuna. Children of the Cataclysmos. Hello, lady. Tardis. Yeah, there's a 2013 version of Age of Empires 2 because it's more remastering, but didn't feel the same. Ah, I see. Yeah, I did hear of a remaster that sort of resurfaced the popularity of that game.
Zalik.
So, Fusion City, person, major, plot, leader, Hezhak, Zanga Brotherhood. Zanga Hoshuda. Zalik as Shazi. Ashazi. Azashi. That's hard to say. Azashi. I'm not Hezhak, that's why. I have trouble pronouncing that name. But he's leader of Zanga Brotherhood. It's also the definitive edition. Because, you know what? Because we're out of ideas. It's so depressing, really. Like, the entire gaming industry is just like, we have no ideas, let's just recreate and remake old games and make them worse. But why, though? I mean, there are good games coming out. It's just that, like, the AAA market right now is just depressing. It's like annual releases of, like, games like FIFA and NBA, Assassin's Creed, and what's that other one? Call of Duty. They just released the same game every year and just changed the clothes, basically. And people buy them anyway. And then there's just a billion remakes. It's like, okay. Can we get a new game? You know, like, I don't know, Factorio. Hades, etc. So who is this? This is a person. Shadow mark. Person, major, plot. And she is the leader of, what are they called? The Promised Land. Haven. Baslik. And she is the leader of the Promised Land. Age of Empires 2 Definitive Edition has better graphics and is all DLC in one game. Yay. There was one company that didn't really figure this whole remaster thing out, though. That is Blizzard. Warcraft 3 Reforged. Wow, did they mess up on that one. Fusion City. Person. Deceased. Police Force. Tupac Klar. Klar.
Aspen Riots.
And he is honestly not a very important person, so he should probably just be under the Aspen Riots, because that's the only thing he has to his had to his name before he died. What Blizzard did? They were like, so hey guys, I know you like Warcraft 3, right? Warcraft 3 is a cool game. We made that, and someone made Dota, and we're kind of still salty about that. But you know, you like the original, right? So we're gonna remake it. And then they show like a trailer and some gameplay footage, and everyone's like, "Ah, yay! This is awesome! New graphics, remastered cinematics, super cool!" And then they release the game, and one, the graphics kind of look like ass. Two, the cinematics are bad. It's like in-game engine cinematics, and it looks nothing like the trailer they released. Like, nothing at all. It's bad. By comparison. It's better than the original, but it's still bad. Compared to what they were promising up until they actually sold the game. No mods work with it. And they removed the original. You can no longer buy or play the original game. You're stuck with Reforged, which is objectively a worse experience. That is like, good job, Blizzard. That's how you piss off an entire community of people. That's like when they announced that Diablo game for mobile, and here's the thing. They announced Diablo Eternals, or whatever it was called. It was a mobile game anyway. And the entire community around Blizzard is kind of like cult-like. They have some really rabidly loyal fans. And you can imagine that the people who go to their cons to be the most rabidly loyal of all their fans, who will walk through burning piles of crap to defend Blizzard. And everyone thought they was going to announce this massive new thing. And they announce a mobile game, and the entire crowd that is sitting in this room boos at them. Think back to what I said about rabid fans and the ones of being at cons. They booed them out. Good job, Blizzard. Not even your most rabid fans like what you're doing. And they respond with, "Do you guys not have mobile phones?" It's like, how can you be so out of touch with your player base? Sorry, I can rant. See, ranting about AAA industry is almost as fun as ranting about D&D. So, if you get me going, I go. Hey, Andromeda was good. It was just rushed to release and then dropped within the first 6 months of the release. Yeah, it was also like 1% of what they planned. Andromeda was going to have like 30 planets and long storylines and stuff, and it ended up with, what, 3? And an animation system that didn't work, etc., etc. But from what I hear, the game mechanics were good, because I think they did them first. Also, they tried to make an entire new game in a new engine. Like, we go from Mass Effect 3, which was not a great game, it was okay, with an awful ending. But they had the engine, they had all the tools, they had everything established so they could just spit out a new game relatively quickly. But to make Andromeda, they change engines to an engine they've never used. Nothing can be ported, nothing can be used from their old games to the new games. They have to remake everything from scratch. They give them a smaller team with less time and a super ambitious project. And the team had never worked on a project that big before. I'm not sure how no one saw that one coming. It's like, oh God. AAA, what are you doing? You're like a train wreck happening in slow motion. You can't look away. Or at least used some of the Frostbite engine used by Inquisition. Yeah. Because they managed to not fuck that up, so I don't know what happened. I mean, I know what happened, but it's baffling anyway. It's almost like another game that was recently released. That which I shall not name because everyone knows what it is. Which was an utter disaster and disappointment. AAA knows they can name a franchise and make a lot of money while releasing garbage. Oh yeah! Again, that's why FIFA and Assassin's Creed and Call of Duty, that's the name, exist. They milk money, but they release the same game with barely any changes. Like, okay. Cool. Oh, you're a Viking now. Cool. It's still Assassin's Creed and it's boring as balls. Alright, cool. No offense if you like the Assassin's Creed games. Good for you. Enjoy them. I do not. I played the first one, I played the second one, and by the end of the second one, I was thoroughly tired of the mechanics, so when the third one came out, I was like, I think I'm gonna skip this one, maybe they'll make another one later, and then the fourth one came out, and I was like, okay, no, I'm done, and we're up to, what, 9 now, or is it 7? I don't know. I was like, nah, I'm done. They did one thing really well, though. The multiplayer mode of... Was it Assassin's Creed 3? I don't know. It was 2 or 3. With the whole kill people by observing them thing. I mean, it had been done before. I think it's called The Ship. That game. But it was still good multiplayer. I like the idea. They did that good. Wasn't too keen on the single player, though. Why am I looking at the recently updated articles? That's not what I'm supposed to look at. I'm supposed to look at what? Criminal organizations. The Angel Syndicate. Ugh, I had no idea where they are. I felt like they tried more to be historically accurate in earlier games. I don't think historical accuracy was ever... Like, I don't think historical accuracy was ever on the table. What I think they were trying to do was to do historical fantasy. So you could... It would be accurate in appearance. Like, if you looked at it, you would see this is Jerusalem. This is Venice, etc., etc. You could recognize it, but it was... I mean, people and... The whole assassin thing and the Templar thing, none of that is historical, so obviously. The weapons they use are anachronistic, the fighting styles they use are anachronistic, the clothes they use are conspicuous as balls. I always loved the fact that you could just basically escape the guards by running away, going around a corner and sit down on a bench and hold your head down. And they would just like, where did he go? It's like, he's wearing an assassin hood. He's the only guy in the entire city who wears an assassin hood, and he's sitting on a bench right in front of you and you don't recognize him. Good job. But yeah, it was more like historical fantasy. I think they did that well. And I mean, hey, for Assassin's Creed Valhalla, they actually hired an Old Norse professor. Anyway, Daniel Jackson. No, Dr. Jackson. Dr. Jackson Crawford. He was actually hired to do the Norse stuff in Valhalla. So they're making an effort. I recognize that. I just don't find their gameplay loop to be interesting in the least. And the story, they lost me in the second game. It was like, okay, this ending sucked. Thanks, guys. These need to be somewhere. I don't know where. Dr. Cowboy Viking? Yes. Dr. Cowboy Viking. That was a lot of V sounds that I didn't get right. I was meaning that the setting had landmarks that were time accurate. Yeah. I think many of the Viking characters in Valhalla are voiced by Nordic people. That's probably the best way to get the accents to work the best. But still, I feel like accents are a bit overrated. And I'll tell you why. Because if you have a person who lives... Okay, let's take Assassin's Creed Valhalla as an example. If you take people who live in-game in the Norse countries, they wouldn't be speaking English with a Norse accent. They would be speaking Old Norse, and they wouldn't have an accent. So it would make more sense to have them have no accent at all. Just speak plain English, because, you know, that's kind of what I did when the role-playing character I had in World of Warcraft, who was a Gudobashi troll. Whenever I spoke, you can switch, if you haven't played World of Warcraft, you can switch what language you're talking or speaking, and whenever you type something, it would come out as gibberish, recognizable gibberish, because it would be like translated to that language with nonsense words, but you could recognize the language, so you could see, okay, he's speaking troll, or he's speaking orcish, etc. And whenever I spoke in troll, I would have no accent whatsoever. I didn't change a single word, I just wrote in straight English. But if I spoke orcish, which my character wasn't very good at, I had a very thick troll accent, which in this game and this culture would be like a Jamaican-ish style. So I would cut off words and I would speak like mon instead of man and stuff like that. So it would be hard to read when I wrote in orcish, but when I spoke in troll, it would be clean. That's how I used to display disparaging language skills. And I think that accents are... I know they evoke the feeling, but it's still strange to me when you have like a movie like what's it called? My brain. Hunt for Red October, for instance. Most of that movie is spent on a Russian atomic nuclear submarine. And everyone is speaking with fake Russian accents, and it's just weird because they would be speaking Russian. They even make an effort in the beginning of the movie that everyone does speak Russian, and then they have one of those transition scenes when someone is reading poetry. They zoom in on his mouth, and then suddenly he transitions to English, and then they speak English ever on. But with a Russian accent, and that's just weird to me. It would make more sense for me if they spoke English. I think I'm probably alone in this opinion, but I feel like having fake accents is just weird. It takes me out of the experience. Yeah, English with Norse accent is a way of indicating that they're actually speaking Norse. Yeah, I know. I know that's why they do it, but to me that's unimmersive. It makes less sense to me than just speaking straight English. What I would like to do, which would be a fuck ton of work, would be to have them speak Old Norse and subtitle it. I would enjoy that much more, but ain't nobody got time for that. Also, I hear that Americans really, really don't like subtitles. So whenever someone is speaking in another language and they have to read, Americans get upset, I hear, which is also strange. But that's maybe because I grew up in Sweden and we watched English movies and they were subtitled in Swedish. Or dubbed. But we really only dub children movies because children can't read that fast most of the time. So they're dubbed. But otherwise, other movies we don't dub. I love my sweet, sweet subtitles. Yeah, but I've heard that's the I've heard that argument. I don't remember who he was. It was a director somewhere who said that that was the reason that they don't do languages like that because people don't like to read subtitles. I think NPCs in Valhalla speak Old Norse and Old English when not talking to the player, which is even weirder because then you make the dissonance even bigger, because they're speaking the correct language and then suddenly they speak English with you. Like, what language are we speaking anyway? I think that's a worse way to do it, to be honest. That's a lot of organizations. I think we're gonna leave those for now, because that's gonna... important. Country... I'm just gonna give up. When I grew up, everything was either in English with subtitles or Swedish, since nobody bothered to dub into Norwegian. I didn't know that. I thought they dubbed like Disney movies and stuff into Norwegian. Children of the Cataclysm. Location. Building. Cathedral. Children of the Cataclysm. Summer Camp 2019. Where is this again? It's in Plaza Downs. So the Children of the Cataclysm should be in Plaza Downs, because that's their headquarters. So, Children. Organization. Disney movies were dubbed into Norwegian, virtually everything else was dubbed into Swedish. I see. For Americans, there's probably no difference between Swedish and Norwegian. I would say probably not. I mean, even as a Swede, I can objectively say that Norwegian and Swedish are very similar. There's more difference in the pronunciation and language melody than there is in actual spelling. They're very similar. Plaza Downs. Fusion City. Organization. Religion. Cult. Children of the Cataclysm. Plaza Downs. There we go. Some Norwegian dialects are super similar to Swedish. Yeah. And some Swedish dialects are surprisingly similar to Norwegian. When I'm at my fiance's parents' place in Värmland, which is very close. Värmland is big, but it's close to the Norwegian border. When we go certain places there, because their dialects vary a lot. Like, in a very small circle, if you just go to the next town over, they can have a vastly different accent or dialect. And in one of the places where we usually go to shop, they have a dialect that is very Norwegian sounding. It's probably not as bad as it is further west, but to me, as a non-Värmlander, it's very reminiscent of Norwegian. And some of the words they use and some of the pronunciations of vowels and stuff are very reminiscent of Norwegian, so makes sense. According to my word smashing in Google Translate, the difference is generally stuff like K instead of C, G instead of J swaps, but the same sounds are slightly different. What do you mean by that? Oh, you mean the difference between Norwegian and Swedish? Grums is a special place. Yes, yes it is. It is indeed. Perimeter wall should be under perimeter, and I don't know why it isn't already. Fusion City. What? Fusion City location. Perimeter. Perimeter wall. state. Yeah, Norwegians don't use C for the K word, as far as I know. Or they don't use C for the K sound. They use K instead. While in Swedish, it's unfortunately mixed. It depends on the context and where the word came from and what vowels follow, if it's K or C. Which is really obnoxious, but most of the time you can probably get it right like 90% of the time if you just assume it's an S sound. Because in Swedish, C is usually an S sound, especially at the beginning of words. In the middle of words, now that I think about it, do we have lone C's in the middle of words? I don't think we do. We always have them standing together with a K. Because the Finnish have double consonants, so they can have like KK. Swedish, you can't really do that unless it's a compound word. Otherwise, it turns into CK. Sorry. Otherwise, it turns into CK, which would be a shortening consonant sound. So the vowel before would become short. So instead of vok, which is a long A sound, we say A, not A. We have a straight vowel, not a freaking diphthong, you American weirdness. But vok, which is V-A-K. But if you would put a C-K, it would be vak. Then it's a short A. Oh, you use K-K too. Okay. Circus. Oh, right. Circus. No, in Swedish we say circus with a K. It's C in the beginning, so circus with K. That's an actual K. The English spell it with a C-C, but we spell C-K. Weirdly enough, but it makes sort of sense. We only use C if the word is imported. Yeah, kind of we do. And then I didn't cry because I was a genius and decided to use a family of languages my own language come from, and then I had to go synonym hunting to avoid looking like I'm trying to be super edgy with English words and misspelling them. Lol. Shadrach Hydroplans. This is wrong. It's not a geographic location. It's a building. This should be moved. So I'm gonna have to put this on the to-do list. Move to landmark building. Rewrite. Expand. But it should be under Shadrach Fields. No, it should be under Shadrach Foods. Because that's the company that owns them. And Shadrach Foods should be under Shadrach Fields. Shadrach Food. No C's allowed. Okay, Demi unleashed a not totally all clear but should be working message. Oh wow, that took a while. Wow. But it's been working fine here, so that's okay.
Shadrach Foods.
Should be under Shadrach Fields. Fusion. City, organization, corporation, major, Shadrach Foods, Shadrach Fields. Yes, that is why they have Shadrach in the name. Shadrach Foods, this is a corporation. What would that be? Manufacturing? They're making food. Business, commerce, conglomerate, entertainment, finance, financial. What's the difference? Manufacturing, medical, mining, pharmaceutical research and development, security. I would say manufacture. I mean, they're making food, but eh. Yes, it's manufacture. Thalcorp Tower. Fusion City. Location. Building, tower, building, tower, headquarters, Tower of Power challenge. Thalcorp. Thalcorp Enterprises. Where is it? Oh, it's in Vault of Heaven. Ooh. Okay, Vault of Heaven. I thought that was below that. Ooh, Thalcorp's a rich-ass corporation to have their headquarters in the Vault of Heaven. Alright, let's reload this. That should be all the buildings, right? Fusion City, important buildings, yes. Delete. We do not need it! Recognize this music at the end of Markiplier's Scary Games. Correct! That is indeed. The artist's name is Shirk, and the song is called Haunted. Though I prefer the remix made by Jonathan, but still, both are good songs. Okay, you know what? I'm tired, and organizing makes me stressed. So, what we're gonna do is we're gonna hop on over to here, and we're going to say goodbye to the YouTube peeps, and I will see you in the next one. Ta-da!